look at that, Kif has absolutely flown off the start. I'm going to take that opportunity. You don't have to ask me twice. Hello everyone, welcome back to Cody's League Championship. So it is of course then the second round in Spain. As I mentioned previously, we're not following a full calendar. And you can see here with this new screen I've got, that's the current standings. I'm currently Apex Online Racing, me and Ownage are 1 point behind Nebula after a bit of a lacklustre start to the season. And see, I managed to put it on poll as well. Strategy, three stop, option, prime, and there's a 51% chance of rain in this race. So quite high. I would expect to see some rain at some point, and usually that does mean that you get the rain about halfway through the race. That's usually how it works. But anyway, here we go then. We're on the grid. 1-2 for me and Ownage on in qualifying at least, so hoping to hold on to that. And fingers crossed we can get a solid result for AOR, which we did fail to do. Me only getting P3 and Ownage, I think it was only P5 or 6. Apologies for the audio there. I think it must have clicked off the game. But anyway, we're on Rich now. Five lights, full throttle start as always. And as mentioned previously, the lag is much better in this race. We had a lot of lag last race, but it wasn't barely any this race. And look at that, Ownage is already all over my rear wing. He's defending quite heavily, using lots and lots of curves. Morden and Rich has been going to standard now. And on the inside, nice, so I should be okay. And there we go. Managed to take the lead into the first corner. Ownage just behind nicely, so we still hold on to our 1-2 lead for now. And things crossed, we can hold on to that for the whole race. But looks like I'm going to Rich and I'm to defend against Ownage. He's coming up the inside again. No, he's not. He's going on the outside now. And managed to hold on to that once again. Hold it nicely on the inside there. But again, he's still all over me, so I expect I'm going to stay defensive. I am indeed. Stick to the middle of the track. And crossing us both quite a lot of time, this is. It looks like Ownage went a little bit deep there. Right box is right up his inside now. And I'm going to stay wide here to give Ownage the slipstream, not right box. Right box for Afro League in the Williams. And as mentioned previously, Kifler isn't racing this race. Of course, the winner for the last round. Nebula put someone else in instead, so that's why there's no Mercedes up here just yet. But right box definitely a strong competitor in the Williams Rafa League, and they're not far behind us on points either, so we need to be mindful of that. But for now, me and Ownage holding it together for a 1-2. I'm just trying to push now. Now I've got Ownage slightly further away, just enough that I don't have to defend. I can now try and push and build the gap if I can. But we know he's a very, very quick driver. So, and I know just interestingly editing this video. And of course, I know with the benefit of hindsight what happens after this, but that we actually battled quite a lot in this race. You know, you already see me defending a lot, whereas as the season goes on, we get more and more teamwork, and we don't really battle at all come the end race. We just purely work as a team, and that's what this league is all about. So I was quite surprised to see us battling, actually. But at least it makes it entertaining to watch and see only just once again all over my rear wing. He must have an awesome first couple of corners. I've gone right to the inside there. And it's going to be on the outside. I wouldn't imagine he can make that work. No, he can't. Leaving plenty of room there, but not now. And there we go. And I don't actually defend this time. He doesn't have a look down the inside. I just decide to make sure I can break nice and late, which I did, and still manage to make my apex, which is good. And he's fallen back a little bit since I didn't defend that time. And Spain's never... Oh, but it will spin there. Spain's never my strongest track. It never has been. I don't think it ever will be. I'm not good at high downforce tracks. That's only just back, actually. So popping it on pole ahead of him was quite impressed with that. I'm going to Rich again there. And obviously the gap now to right box. 1.3 seconds between, I think it's between Ownage and right box. So a little bit of a gap now getting outside of DRS, which is good. But Ownage will now get DRS on me, I expect. So hopefully we can though still kind of work together and just try and pull away. Because we could do with this 1-2. It will definitely help us loads in the points. A bit of a correction there. Almost had quite a big cut, but corrected last second. And there we are, Rich now. Rest of my curves as well. And yeah, Ownage did get DRS, I believe. Yes, he did. And right box didn't. No, he didn't. 1.2 it was. We skip ahead now on from the beginning of lap 3 to the end of lap 3. You can see that Ownage is all over me now. And he will, of course, get DRS. Got a bit of curves, though, to use. But so he didn't. Must not have any curves. I managed to pull away a little bit there. And only half a second, though, so he'll be quite close to me come the first corner, I'd imagine. Just keep my eye on him there. Keep flicking backwards, and he's going to be all over me. I'm going to have to defend on the inside here. And he doesn't try anything on the outside through this corner. That'd be rather foolish. But it will spin there, though. Sliding through that first corner. not what we want to do. And he's all over me. Look in the mirror. Look at that behind. All over me. And he's on the outside once again. So similar to a couple of laps ago. And I must admit, I did miss battling with Ownage editing this video. I was very much enjoying it. Because, I mean, just these opening four laps, I didn't think I really had that in AOR recently. So just the opening four laps, and it's already awesome battling. And you see this all over my rear wings. I'm going to throw it inside, but no, he's not quite going to manage to make that stick, so I'm not going to give him much room. We won't allow that. Don't allow people to dive at your inside like that. Cut him off. And we've got DRS down here as well, but too far back to do anything about it. And yeah, just what I was saying, I do miss the battles with Ownage, and like I said, it's in this video, just constant, there we are, look, go tiniest little bit deep, and he's all over me, straight away, there is no breathing room. Yes, he is faster than me in this race, but there's just, you've just got to be so on top of your game. Smallest mistake, and he's either through, or he's all over you, and going to be probably attacking you to the next corner. You've just got to keep it so clean, and looks like I'm going to dive into the pits now then. Lap 4, and that's actually lap early than I intended. And I believe that's because Ownage is going to pit next lap, so I'm actually going to options there as well. So that's an interesting move. I think I'm hoping for rain fairly soon. I don't want to lose the pace with the primes, even though they last longer. So I'm actually going for a second set of options, so I'd expect to come back out in the lead. Held by a couple of tenths in the pits there, not too bad. And there's an Afro-D driver there. Was that right, Box? No, it was, no, it's Boss, I believe. So there we are, nice big gap now. And we'll stick with this outlap, because we will need to push just to make sure we get a bit of a gap to Ownage. So a few of you requested me to do more complete laps in my edit, so that's what I've done with this video, so do let me know what you think of it. If you'd rather me do complete laps, or rather have a shorter video that's more action-packed. Can you see by the mini-map, I'm probably not going to be battling anyone on this outlap. But of course, it is an important lap, because I need to get straight on the pace to become ahead of Ownage. I need to really feel for these new tyres now. Really feel what grip they got, use all the grip available. You can see there, that was just nice there. Didn't quite make the apex, but the speed was just right through that corner. And looking ahead, that Lotus is actually in the gravel, so lots and lots. Whoa, big speed difference. Big speed difference, and luckily he stayed more or less out of the way. And I've got a little bit deep there. So, well, I said there wasn't going to be any action on this outlap. That was a complete lie in the end. And he made a mistake there, and I managed to take him. So, nice and easy. They didn't hold me up at all, which is, of course, what I need when I'm battling Ownage so hard. You can see it at the minimap there, Ownage and right box, both box, I believe. And yes, they do. So, hopefully, I should be ahead of them. I've had a pretty clean outlap of night. Pretty solid stuff. Just taking that chicane nicely. And that's what you need to do for that chicane. Easy said and done. Just be right on the white line, but don't cut or extend. And it's so hard through there. So easy to do. And let's have a look down there. Yep, just trundling down the pit exit now. And that's, there it is. Miles ahead. Look at that. Absolutely miles ahead. And we'll stick with this for the end of the first sector just to see a gap. But I do believe Ownage was on primes there. I can confirm Ownage is on primes. So he's gone a slightly different way to me, interestingly. So we'll see how that plays out. We're kind of edging our bets, though, for this rain, which is expected to come roughly halfway through the race. But there we are, 2 second gap then to Ownage behind. And skip ahead now to lap 6. Oh, it's now lap 7. Managed to do a purple lap, just the end of that last lap that was. Purple lap DRS now on the guy ahead in the Red Bull. Got quite short rev, so we're not going to go up the inside, but go slow-mo now. And looks like he's braking very early. Going to have to dive at the inside, sort of force. We can see him there just kind of move off the track. And that did look like lag to me, so I will now wait for him. Which I didn't want to do, of course, having that little gap to Ownage, but didn't really have a choice. And now getting on it again. And, yeah, that was a lag move, but that was because he braked so early. He took me by surprise a little bit. And looks like he's backed out of it there to let me through. Does want to get hit again, of course. And I did feel bad, but I did wait, so can't say fairer than that. And, yeah, unfortunately, big lag there. But I spotted it, didn't just pretend that it didn't happen on my screen and just crack on. I did spot it and let him back through. Lap 8 now then, the lap ahead, and Sir Cal ahead in the Ferrari, who is driving for the F1 racing community, and all over him now going to get some DRS. I imagine I'll dive inside using a bit of curves. He's going to defend to the inside, but no, not going to swap to the inside, decided against that, but he's gone a little bit deep, so see if I can just tuck it under them, him there, which I've just managed to do. Lots of oversteer on the exit there, and oh no, going to be around the outside through this corner, which is not easy. It looks like I've got a bit of a grip advantage. He's still on primes. Perhaps he's even the tyres he started on. In fact, he is on the tyres he started on. So, had a big pace advantage there. And he's holding up Ownage beautifully behind. They just saw in the mirrors there. Look at that. And Ownage is going to get DRS from that. But he must have held him up quite badly there. Probably lost at least half a second to him. So, I'm getting a few tenths back in the DRS. But, and what's the gap? 2.2 to Ownage again now. So, overall, the traffic was even to both of us, which is good. And you see that Ownage is definitely getting DRS. So he's probably going to take me here. And I see, look at that on the right-hand side there. My tyre, front left tyre, is absolutely destroyed. It's not pretty, so I'm not going to defend this now. I'm just going to let Ownage go for it. And I'm just holding him up from now with him on primes. He's going to be miles faster than me, so don't even bother defending that one. Just try and keep it consistent. Go to slow-mo now. Look, lots of wheel spin there. Just very late correcting. I was just a little bit asleep there. Managed to just keep out the gravel. Do I know? Little tap in the gravel, but managed to get back on track very quickly, actually, considering I was flying towards that walnut gravel. But now we've got Ryobox behind then. And he's going to come on the outside using some curves. I've gone to Rich as well. Don't want to try and let him get an easy move. Going to try and stay up the inside here, but had to break early. Look, yeah, look, no grip. Front left tyre's gone, so fortunately I had to let him through as well. So disappointing. They could have at least held him up a little bit longer, but just wasn't possible there. And an uncharacteristic mistake for me there. Like I said, I think I just got a little bit lazy. I had some oversteering, just didn't correct it till it was too late. And I'm pretty amazed I managed to more or less keep out of the gravel, though. But it looks like Ryobox has gone deep, though, the very same lap. And can I just sneak back through on him? Yes, I can. So that's good. I'm going to hold him up a little bit. He is, of course, me and Ownage's main rival by far. So because of my destroyed front left, I'm holding up quite heavily now. He'll lose probably at least half a second to me in his final sector alone. And a little bit deep there, though. He's going to go inside, but I want to go to the pit, so I'm going to have to get on the brakes to get across to the pit lane. So that definitely cost me time. So overall, we were just costing each other time there. It wasn't ideal. And yeah, me went deep there. I just had to brake and just come across. I'd have taken him out. And looks like I'm going for primes this time. So prime tyres, hopefully these will last now till the rain, which we still don't know when that'll be. But hopefully they will last me. The rain shouldn't be too much longer. Like I say, usually when it's 51%, that means you get about halfway through the race. And it's like Kramer ahead, who is actually an AOR driver, not in this particular league. And Salvi's actually driving slipstreamers in this league, but he is very much an AOR driver, I believe. I believe he's more of an AOR driver than a slipstreamers driver, but I could be wrong. And you see the tyres already up to temperature on the right-hand side there, more or less. 1.3 to Kramer now. Oh, bit of, ooh, lots of oversteer Kramer got then. Wow. This car was just wobbling around on the exit there, wasn't it? And he doesn't look like he's got very much grip at all. So I'm already on him, already well under a second, so I've gained at least half a second on him in those last few corners alone. And look at that, he's just got no grip. And oh, he's even going to let me through. So there we are. I mentioned before, he is an AOR driver, so he just opted to let me through there, which is good of him. And that was my engineer telling me rain in 15 minutes then. So I don't know if these tyres will last that long. 15 minutes, what's that? Probably about 13 laps-ish. So that's the sort of thing it would work out in my head when I'm going around. How many laps it was, I'll be more accurate though when I'm actually driving, because I take a bit more time to do it. But I'm concentrating on commentating right now. Commentating for me is probably actually harder than driving. I've probably got less mental reserves when commentating than I have when driving. Weird enough. But anyway, back to the action now. Got Ryobox, who I believe is just boxed. And we were, of course, just behind him as we came into the pits. And there he is on the inside there. He's come out the pit exit. This is going to be very, very close come the end here. And I've got better speed than him. It looks like I managed to brake later than him and just cut him off there. Just had to turn in and hope that he hadn't outbraked himself. And thankfully, he's a decent driver, so he didn't do that. And wow, you don't get much closer than that, do you? So it's important that Kramer let me through there. If he didn't let me through, I wouldn't have been ahead of Ryobox there. And I need to push now to try and build a bit of a gap to get him out of DRS while his tyres are still warming up. And looks like we've got that Silicent I'm going to go with. Probably not right ahead again. Looks like he's going to go inside there. His tyres aren't great either by the looks of it. And we'll see if we can catch them. We won't catch him in this DRS, but Ryobox is all over me though. Do we have options or primes? I didn't quite see. I assume he's got primes. Can't quite see from this distance, but he has got DRS, so he might close in on us. So I should go purple, fast of anyone through the first two sectors. And I still can't quite see what Ryobox is on. I'm just now concentrating on pushing, trying to get DRS on the car ahead. Definitely got a pace advantage with these tyres. These tyres are a lot older than mine, so just pushing. There's lots of traffic ahead, but see if I can just squeeze the DRS. There's a Williams there as well, the Afro League, with one of our competitors. And I think I might have got it, you know, just about. Everyone else boxed, so unfortunately he will get DRS ahead as well. And I believe this is the guy that I took out in the first corner, so I'll try not to do it again. I'm using a bit of curves this time, because I know he's going to get DRS and trying to get to full speed quicker, and doubt that's going to work. No, I braked a bit earlier this time. Ooh, still pretty close to him, but I did brake a little bit earlier this time because I was aware of the mistake I made last time. Trying not to do it again. And I will get a little bit of slipstream now, though. I'm going to try and get the move done as quick as I can, so he's not holding me up. Ryobox is only a second back. And is he going to leave the inside? Yes, he is. So I'm going to dive at the inside. I have an absolute lunge. Oh, a bit of contact there, but I do leave him plenty of room. Can't argue with that. And is that move done? Well, he's still on the outside for now. Not move done for now. Going to leave him a bit of room. And looks like he's probably outbraked himself there. Yes, he has, by quite some weight. So, well, Rybox is now going to get DRS on him, but hopefully he holds him up through this corner at the very least, which he has done. Quite a big extend there, so we might not even get past him. But, we do skip ahead then to lap 19. And you see there's just a few spits of rain, but look at the tyre on the right-hand side. My front left is, well, not destroyed yet, but it's not great. Managed to keep Rybox behind me. 6.5 seconds to Ownage now, so far my strategy calls have not worked, have they? And 6 tenths then, so barely anything, but it looks like I might pit. Well, because it's a bit of rain, I'm going to go for options and hope that the rain comes in time. And see that, didn't get held up by Rybox this time, coming into the pit entry. And, well, okay. I'm obviously expecting the rain to get a bit heavier because it was just sort of spitting there, wasn't it? Just only starting to rain lap 20. So that's more or less half through the race, as I said. And it is just spitting, so we might get away with it. Didn't really get held up in the pits there, which is nice. Option tyres then. Well, I'm sitting here now. And I personally think that's the wrong choice as I'm commentating this race. We've got a car now on our right side, though. It's a Mercedes, but no, he's going to be miles past us. Andrea, who I believe is also an AOR driver. Most of these drivers actually drive an AOR. And, well, option tyres then. So we've got to hope the rain comes down quite thick and fast. Otherwise, these tyres will die. They only last about 5 laps or so. Not long at all. 4 or 5 laps. In fact, oh, bit of kerb there. Managed to correct it. I was more alert that time, wouldn't I? Very quick on the oversteer correction then. And that's what you need to be. And this game's not too bad for it. You can be quite lazy this game, to be honest. But you do need to be on it and be ready. But look at this. A big pace advantage over Andre ahead now. He's actually Nebula. So I'm almost a pit stop ahead of him. But it might not play out like that. If his strategy doesn't work and bit occurs there, DRS is wide open. We'll have a look up the inside. Yes, I will. He's going to let me have a look by the looks of it. Can I get all slowed down? Yes, I can. Nailed the apex that time. And he has a little come inside there, but no, he's not got the grip to do that. So that's the move done on him. Nice move done there. Nice solid move. And so, does Rybox pit then? That's the only guy that we're really racing. The Ownage is now miles down the road. That's that mistake I made. And also, him using primes all the way so far. And no, he doesn't. No, he does not. The two cars ahead stay out then. So, Rybox has not boxed. Well, will that play into his advantage with the rain? And we're coming up then to another Mercedes. That'll be another Nebula driver, Max Shepard. Again, looks like he's lacking for grip quite badly. Not going to dive the inside there. It'd be too much. But again, might be able to get with the inside to next corner. And wow, look at that big grip difference. I just had so much more grip to get it turned through that corner and then get on the power on the exit. Being plenty of room on the outside then. Yep, move done. Nice and easy. No messing about. I need to get through this traffic as quickly as I can. A lot of traffic all race, haven't I? But managed to carve through it nicely, apart from that one mistake I made when I lagged someone off the track. And it's Mini Blackhead again, another AOR driver. And I'm not sure if Max Shepard's an AOR driver. I don't think he is, but I'm not too sure on that one. But lap 22 now. The rain's starting to come down, but it's not very heavy, is it? It's not heavy. It's just still only spitting. So this call is getting less and less likely to work out, to be honest. And nice and close to the Mini Black. Should be a monster passing with a DRS. And look at this. Yeah, that'll be easy. There we go. So, back into P2 then. As it looks like Rybox did pit that lap as well, so he's a long, long way back though. So, again, quite a few seconds on Rybox. But look at this now. There's a guy on Inters there, and look at that. He's got no grip. He has got no grip, so not ready for Inters yet. So, I need to stay out, I believe. And I hope I don't box his lap. That'll be too early, surely. But I'd imagine I'll stay out. Yes, I do. So, not ready for Inters yet. Lap 23 then. Coming on to lap 24. Not ready for Inters. Lap 26, still out on these option tyres. Wow, and I believe is that 6 laps on the tyres? So, it's looking better now though. There's some spray coming off the tyres. Still only spitting really, isn't it? But spray on the tyres is usually a good indicator. And, 9.5 seconds to finish now, so I've made the wrong calls this race to beat him for sure. But nice 6 second gap, I believe that was, to right box. So, should be able to beat him. A little bit of oversteer there, so I'm going to box his lap. It looks like Ownage's as well. Ownage's in the pits. I can tell you, I do cut out the team radio purely because I haven't got my team radio saved, so it'd be a bit pointless just listening to Ownage, but we did communicate via team radio and we agreed we were both going to box for Inters. We were communicating saying, how does it feel to you? How does it feel to you? Is it ready? Is it ready? And we both agreed, so we both boxed on the same lap, double stacked the cars, and it looks like Rybox has managed to sneak into the lead there, has he? Yes, yeah. No, he hasn't actually. Ownage is still in the lead. Rybox stayed out for now, so he did not box. Looks like we're the first people to go onto Inters, barring that guy who went way too early. And that strategy call wasn't too bad for me then, was it? Riding these work, looks like they got good grip. wasn't too bad for me. Could have been worse. The tyres were quite worn towards the end, but they weren't gone off the cliff, so wasn't too bad. I got away with it, I think. So I'm just delaying the downshift there, just because I want to wait to see, listen to the car, see how much grip I've got. If I lose the rear end, again, very deep there. And actually left the downshifts way too late that time. But you see the front left is warming up, so it's not quite ready for incident. Wasn't the perfect lap, would have been the next lap probably. And I expect that's when right box will box. No pun intended. And got full charge cars using a little bit now. And yeah, like I say, so just see if I do it here. No, I didn't delay that downshift that time because I'm now more confident with the level of grip I've got. But when you downshift aggressively, that can of course lock the rear tyres. And when there's no grip, you don't want to be locking the rear tyres. So just delaying the downshifts there, just using the brakes. And when I'm confident that the rear is not going to stick, then I shift the gears. And I'll often do that anyway. And even in dry conditions, but even more so wet conditions, a little bit deep there, but not too bad. And this is now ready for inters. So probably one lap too early, but we still had a nice big gap to right box. And it looks like right box still hasn't boxed, though. Now he has finally boxed. So a whole another lap later, and we're going to be miles ahead of him now. So a nice, comfortable 1-2 then for AOR, me and Ownage for now. But look at this, though. Lap 30 of 33, and look how much range on the screen. Really quite wet now. And 13.5 seconds now to Ownage. And, well, the rear tyres are starting to cool down. 6 seconds to right box. There's not much grip through there at all. Is it wet weather time? Is it wet weather tyres time? Big call to make here. And, well, I can tell you, only just boxed. And I'm going to box as well. Again, team radio, we communicated. We both agreed full wet weather tyres is the way to go. We were just losing grip. Didn't feel great at all. We thought, right, it's about to be wet weathers. We need to box. So we both boxed. Again, same lap. And we're just leaving the pits now. And the right box goes through, but I'm sure we have to come for wets very soon. And here we go, and trending down the pit lane. Should have a nice clear gap to the car behind. And look at that on the minimap. Look on the minimap. Ownage has gone off the track. And I can tell you again, team radio, he said, not ready for full wets. Very, very careful first turn. And look at that. Absolutely no grip. It's like I'm on ice. Look at this. No grip at all. Completely the wrong move from both me and Ownage. We've simultaneously made the same mistake. By trying to be clever and communicating via team radio, we've made the same mistake. And, wow, what a poor call. Only 8.5 seconds, so he's lost 5 seconds that first sector to me. But look at these tyres on the right-hand side. Absolutely overheating, boiling hot, completely wrong. We're going to have to box. We're going to have to box. We can't be this slow till the end. We will be stone cold last. And look at that. I'm going to be absolutely eaten alive by these cars behind now, who are still on inters. And, well, let's see then. How much more grip have you got, guys? I'm going to pretty much let him pass. I'm not going to literally let him through, but I'm going to try and give him space on the outside. Oh, whoa, big contact there. That must have been a side pod glitch because I got pushed sideways there. Where's Minibat gone? I went out to the gravel. Big side pod glitch there. And look at this. They're just flying past, but I can't even make it through there. Someone else is firmly inside. Wow, what a poor call. Go back to the team radio, as I said, as I was leaving the pit exit. Owens had already dived into the first corner. And finally had no grip, and again getting overtaken. Finally had no grip and said, be very, very careful in the first corner. No grip, no grip. And which is, of course, why I braked so early. So I effectively saved 5 seconds by Ownage helping me out there, but wow. Wow. We look dead set for a 1-2. Both made the same simultaneous mistake. Boxing again now for intermediate tyres. And where are we going to be? I'm P8 now, P9 now. There's another car coming. I'm going to be P10. You know, Owen's just ahead. He's going to be P9. Okay. From the heights of a 1-2 to the lows of a P8 and P10. Wow. What a mistake we've made there. And we'll skip the out lap, but we'll run the whole final lap. You see, Owen is involved with that little cluster. Not the car ahead on the minimap, the next car, the next lot. But I've got a big gap. To me back ahead, big gap. So I wouldn't imagine I can get there, and I can tell you with the benefit of hindsight that it was tyre wear actually that was doing that. It wasn't the fact that it was ready for wet weather tyres. The tyres were just very, very worn. Unfortunately, I didn't show the graphic on my in lap, but the tyre was very worn, so that's what gave us such bad understeer. So we could have done the box another set of inters and we probably would have been alright, but we made the mistake of thinking it was for full wets. And at the time we didn't realise that the temperature on the right hand side temperature indicator was so good. It never was in previous games. Me or Ownage didn't realise how good it was in this game, and you've really just got to trust that. If they say the tyres are getting cool, it's ready for full wets, and it's as simple as that. And Riot Box manages to take the win then, and I'm looking at this, I'm half a lap down. Wow. And I can tell you, great deal of embarrassment. I'm not going to be able to catch me back, I wouldn't imagine. Mind you, they're going very slowly in this final sector. We'll talk about the race in a minute, but we'll stick with this for now. And look, you can see him now, so we've lost a good few seconds with this lap. So only a few corners left, but if he makes a mistake, if his tyres are completely gone, which I expect they are, which of course mine are almost brand new, and lots and lots of cars just ahead there. And nope, not going to be able to get him. P10. A single point from the heights of 18 points for P2 to the lows of a single point for P10. Wow. I mean, it doesn't get much worse than that. And like I was just saying, I only managed to finish P7, but it was a source of a great deal of embarrassment, in all honesty. But with me and Ownage, we were quite embarrassed. We knew a lot of people from AOR were watching. There was high expectations on our shoulders, of course. I mean, me and Ownage had won the previous three championships for AOR for PC. So we were very much the guys who were expected to do the job and completely let the side down there. So Ridebox managed to take the win. Ownage only P7. Nice recovery for Ownage to get P7, I must say. Me only P10, and look at those standings. Not great. We're a long, long way back now. Long way back. And, well, we've got a lot to do now. We have got a lot to do. It's only a 5-race season. There's 3 races left to go. And I tell you what, we've got a fight on our hands now. We have got a absolutely monumental fight on our hands. And I'm very much looking forward to these next few races. And I can tell you, that race was good, and the following races are also very, very good, particularly the finale. So do keep a keen eye on this series, and I thank you ever so much for watching. Bye-bye.